Hi, this is Rachel Williams with Cattle.com, and we are out here in the yards in Denver 2010, and I believe I have actually just ran into the man who wins the award for the longest distance traveled to the National Western Livestock Show. I'm out here visiting with Chris Davidson of Australia, who comes to Denver every year to look at the outstanding genetics. He's also associated with the Warner Beef Ranch here in the United States.
That's right.
Mr. Davidson, tell us what makes it worthwhile for you to come to Denver every year?
Well, I find it difficult to answer that because I don't like shows. We're commercial cattle people and don't really like shows. Mm-hmm. And I always say we're not coming to a show, we're coming to the biggest cattle event in the world. Mm-hmm. And Herd Bull Alley here, the fact that I can meet cattle breeders from all different breeds, from lots of different regions, as long as you don't get tied up too much in the show part of it, I find it just really, really stimulating. Mm-hmm. And you're right, it's a long way. I've been coming to the United States since 1985. This would be only my fourth Denver, because I try and go and spend most of my time out on the range. But for a short period of time, you can meet a lot of people, you can see a lot of different cattle, you can see a lot of different genetics, you can cover a lot of ground. And probably a term I don't like is networking, but it is a good place to network and meet people. So, yeah, it's a fantastic, fantastic place.
How long is your plane ride over here?
Well, as I get older, it seems to take longer. I think it took me nearly 30 hours to get here this time. Obviously, with heightened security, it's now taking a lot longer to get through security, both on the plane and off the plane. And so it's a fair haul. So it's got to be worthwhile. And because we're professional cattle breeders, it has to be meaningful for what we do. So the show job's not meaningful for us at all. But to be able to go and talk to different breeders here in Herd Bull Alley that are displaying sires and AI companies, that are you can go and talk about some of the sires we're considering using. The pen bulls, we actually exhibited in the pen bulls this year. I think there's a lot of relevance in that as far as a commercial man goes. And yeah, there's just so much to be gained. But like everything else, Rachel, what you get out of it's pretty well what you put into it, eh?
I agree. Well, real quick, as we wrap up, give us a picture of the Australian beef industry versus what we see here in the United States for our viewers at home.
A couple of simple things. You have 300 million people, 100 million beef cattle. You consume 80% of your product. We have 20 million people and 25 million beef cattle, so we export 70% of our product. We don't have corn, we don't have ethanol, and we have very little irrigation, and we have a lot of tropical, arid environment. Subsequently, a lot of our beef gets exported as grinding type beef. You import a lot of beef from us. You import from us a lot of beef that you don't produce, which is grinding type beef. Your industry is not better than our industry or worse than our industry. It is different than our industry because your environment is different. We don't have snow and ice. Ice in our country is what comes in a drink on a hot day. So therefore, your whole production system is very different. So when we go around here and look at genetics, for example, it's really important that we say our markets are different, our production system's different, and our environment's different. Will that work for me? And it's a case of understanding. And when you travel, never say better or worse. Say different. And why is it different? And if you can appreciate the difference, you'll enjoy traveling.
Well, it's all about making friends in the beef industry with people who share a common love for beef cattle and agriculture like we do. And it's been an honor to visit with you. And thank you for your time today. And I know our viewers at cattle.com enjoyed listening to you and learning about Australian beef industry.
Thank you.